there's a good reason why doctors have very long shifts. And when I say long shifts, I am not kidding. On average, U.S. doctors work almost 60 hours a week. And a lot of the time, younger residents work up to 80 hours and have to deal with grueling 24-hour shifts. We wanted to cover the research behind this today because at first glance, those long hours might seem like a disaster waiting to happen. I mean, delivering medical care is stressful, highly demanding work, and doing it on little sleep seems like it would result in people getting hurt. But there is a convincing reason why doctors prefer to keep working instead of handing their patients off to another doctor. And that reason is that it can save lives. This is a relief to me because when I moved to Chicago, I lived with my good friend Blake, and he was in medical school the first 3 years we lived together. And yeah, his hours, brutal.
I've never understood why they did this, and I'm so happy to know now.
Well, yeah, clearly saving lives is a pretty good reason. And this is backed up by a lot of research that has shown that even when training shifts and weekly scheduled hours for doctors are cut back, there haven't been significant changes in the number of lives saved. So what gives? One of the major reasons for this is the risk that goes along with changing a patient's doctor. This routine is known in the medical profession as a patient handoff. Handoffs require a lot of clear communication on every detail about a patient's condition, prognosis, and treatment. When you multiply this by the number of patients usually under a doctor's care, it's pretty much guaranteed the details will be lost without a robust and organized method in place for communicating them. Up to 80% of serious medical errors can trace their origin to miscommunication during patient handoffs. That's why sleep-deprived doctors who have firsthand experience working with a particular patient are less likely to make serious errors than doctors who are wide awake but who are never told about a patient's allergy or another complicating factor. I mean, you know when you show up at the hospital and the doctor asks you, okay, what have you been feeling? What are the symptoms? And you talk to them for like 20 minutes about something. Well, yeah, I mean, that doctor may not be able to repeat that 20 minutes of conversation for 200 patients to the next doctor. It makes sense. These days, hospitals typically enforce strict patient handoff procedures, and they implement their own fatigue mitigation strategies. That can actually include scheduling planned naps, strategically using caffeine, and keeping staff involved when designing work schedules. The future should be brighter since trials are still underway to find the perfect balance for work hours, shift policies, and sleep policies. But for now, it's worth remembering that there is at least one good reason why doctors work such long hours.